so I wanted to do a video here to talk a lot about the annular solar eclipse that's going to be happening as we go into Saturday during the mid-late morning, right around the lunchtime hour, and kind of talk a bit about the difference between this, what it's going to look like outside, and then compare it to what you would see with a total solar eclipse. So this eclipse is a little bit different because it all has to do with the distance that the moon is from the Earth. During a total solar eclipse, the moon is usually pretty close, and so thus you're able to get basically the entire moon is able to block out the sun for a brief amount of time, and it gets really dark outside. But in this case, the moon is going to be a bit farther away from the Earth, which means that the moon will not be able to block all of the sunlight. So this is going to be what it looks like from Oklahoma City. And right now we're looking at about 75% blockage of the moon over the sun. So this is going to be what it looks like as we go outside right around 10 to 11 o'clock on Saturday afternoon. You'll notice here that the sky is still blue. You're probably going to notice a bit of a dim outside, kind of like a dim light outside. May not feel like it's full sun out there, but it's still going to be pretty bright outside. So this is what it looks like with about 75% of the moon blocking the sun. And again, you can see here, it's still pretty bright. It's still pretty bright outside. You may notice, again, a little bit of a dimming out there, but nothing all that much. Another area that I'm going to look at, this is going to be in the path of totality there, out across West Texas. I'm going to pick Odessa, Texas, which is projected to have 100% of the annular solar eclipse ongoing. But again, remember, while the moon is blocking the sun, there's still a good amount of the sunlight still able to get through. And even here, this is Odessa, Texas, it still looks, you know, fairly bright outside. So if you're trying to compare the difference between an annular solar eclipse and a total solar eclipse, look, nothing will ever be able to match what a total solar eclipse looks like. Yeah, if you're looking at this and like trying to rank it on a scale of like 1 to 100 with total solar eclipse being 100, and ask anyone that's ever been in the path of totality when it comes to a total solar eclipse, they'll tell you, look, it's hard to beat that. Like, it gets really emotional for some, but it just gets really, really dark outside. But when it comes to the annular solar eclipse, and I guess you could probably rank it around a 10 or a 15. You know, it's cool when you think about it, and it kind of gives you, I guess, the idea of looking at Earth and the universe that we live in, like three-dimensionally with the sun and the moon and the Earth and all that stuff. But if you're setting your sights on something that's going to just be spectacular out there, I'm afraid you're probably going to have a hard time even knowing that there's a annular solar eclipse going on at the moment, because it's not going to get that dark out there. And really, the only way that you can safely see the moon crossing in front of the sun there would be, you're gonna need some of these solar glasses. And so make sure you need to have those if you're gonna try to look up at the sky to try to see, again, the moon kind of crossing in the path of the sun there. It is not safe to look at with the naked eye, so please keep that in mind. But otherwise, it's cool to think about us having that, but it's not going to get that dark. Now, on the other hand, in April, we will see a total solar eclipse that will make its way across the southern plains. That right there is going to be really, really exciting. Let's just hope there are no clouds in the forecast that day. We'll keep you posted.